Hello, beloved. You're welcome to Eagles Television, where we'll produce and publish news on politics, celebrities, entertainment, and all other news. You know, these days, people have been in the business of taking their lives. But I really think that suicide is not the option. We have God and heaven. You know, we have a word from the superintendent of Assemblies of God, Nigeria. Don't die yet. Suicide not an option. Before I continue, do well by subscribing to the red button below and tap to the bell beside it so that will keep you updated. Key verse, Acts chapter 16, verse 28. But Paul shouted to him, "Stop! Don't kill yourself. We are all here." In recent times, many cases of suicides have been reported and deaths sprawling on the streets. For example, a university admission seeker recently took her life. According to a witness, she was reportedly displeased with the 163 marks she got in the Unified Tertiary Matriculation Examination. To show her disenchantment, she consumed 3 bottles of Snipper and insecticide. The bottles were found by her side the day she was found lifeless. Findings attest to the fact that depression is a major cause of suicide. Depression is a disorder shown by excessive sadness, loss of interest in enjoyable things, and low motivation. Depression has no regard for class, gender, age, tribe, or race. If left unattended to, depression becomes suicidal. 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 4. Depression makes you lose touch of anything good around you. Recycled disappointment is one of the causes of depression. One of the signs of depression is you feel miserable as a result of past mistakes, failures, and events. In Acts chapter 16, the jailer got trapped in depression because of the feeling that he failed miserably in his duty. The prison gates flew wide open and the chains of the prisoners under his custody fell off. He thought the prisoners had all escaped from the prison and may face death as a consequence. As a result, he attempted to commit suicide, but Paul shouted to him, "Stop! Don't kill yourself, we are all here." It's normal to experience feelings of sadness and despair in response to adverse life events, but you should not give in to depression and suicide. Look out for survivors around your environment whom have triumphed over similar life crises you're going through, and leverage on their testimonies to survive and thrive. Paul said, "We are all here," meaning learn from others that have also been through what you're going through, and even much more, yet we didn't give up. Don't kill yourself, beloved. I see light at the end of the tunnel. That situation you're going through now will not kill you, but you will come out victoriously in Jesus' name. Amen. The Bible says his favor is for a lifetime. Weeping may stay for a night, but joy comes in the morning. Psalms chapter 30, verse 3. Don't allow depression blind you from God's help. 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 3. Elijah did a great revival in 1 Kings 18 and performed a great miracle of calling down fire from heaven. He killed 400 prophets of Baal, and later in 1 Kings 19, 4, he asked God to kill him. Depression makes you think you have nothing to offer and tells you that your time season is over. It makes you question all the relationship you have and makes you say things that are not true about God. Depression makes you quickly forget who you were and what God have done through you. It makes you believe you're the only one going through that problem. Everyone is dealing with a problem. The only difference is how you're dealing with yours. You have every reason to be happy despite your challenging situation. The fact that you're still alive is a good reason to thank God. Don't forget that despite your problem, someone is still praying to be like you. Don't kill yourself, for God has not finished with you. After you've suffered a little while, the God of all grace will restore and establish you. 1 Peter chapter 5. Verse 10, don't be moved by your circumstances, but be moved by the word of God. Oh, that's a good one. I am blessed. I am really blessed. Here, Papa is telling us that you should not give up. Rely on the word of God. I am really, my soul is really blessed. Rely on the word of God. Remember, as you are, somebody is praying to be like you. And you want to give up. Do you know that that depression is from the devil? Whenever he knows that God's blessing is around the corner, he wants to bring depression. You know, the devil, first of all, if he wants to destroy you, he steals your joy, the joy of salvation from you. And once he is able to steal your joy, the next is depression and worry and all the rest. But rely on the promises of God on a daily basis. God have promised. If you can rely on his promise, my dear, the devil is a small boy. Thank you and God bless you for watching. This is Eagles Television. We'll keep you updated. God bless you.